Milagros LGBT Center. It's my pleasure to be here tonight to witness this amazing piece of cinema. I really loved it. It was wonderful. So what we're gonna do now is open things up for questions. One thing that I wanted to mention though is I loved, and maybe you could expand on this a little bit, the idea that you did this alone. You are a cis man, you had no real connection to the trans community before, and you took on this project, and you did it with a handheld camera by yourself. You are the entire crew, basically, of this amazing thing. So tell us a little bit about the process, not just the process of following her and watching this amazing transition, transformation.
Thank you. Well, when I decided to make this story, my idea was, okay, when you wanna make a movie, you have different options, you know. I have a production company, so I have different cameras, so I could make like a movie with a different style. But I didn't know nothing about this subject, so I was like, how can I go very deep? And I said, I don't wanna make a movie from outside. I wanna be inside, so I wanna be both characters. So I wanna be the guy who's making the movie, but the guy who's having feelings about what is going on inside. So I said, the only way to be very intimate is the right word? The only way to be there, to be inside and to feel, I'm not a trans person, but I wanted to feel what she was feeling. I said, okay, I have to be there, and it has to be only one person. So I say, okay, I'm gonna take the risk to make a movie with one camera and just only me. Can you imagine with a sound man, you know, doing like this? So it's impossible. And also because the movie was shot illegally, so I basically I didn't have permission to. In the hospital was illegal, in the street, in the subway, you know, it was, and people would ask me, what are you doing? I said, I'm taking pictures. But why? You take so long. I said, well, because I'm professional, you know, it takes me time to take pictures. They didn't know that I was making a movie. So that's, it was very hard. But then when I came back and I made the final cut, I said, well, I have the movie, I don't have the permissions. So how am I gonna do? So I sent the movie to them and said, listen, okay, I wasn't taking pictures, it's true, but, you know, please give me the permission, you know, the hospital, sign me this paper. So basically, this process was, I took the decision to make it, you can see in my camera is, I'm moving all the time, no steady cam, no sound man. So Morgana became very famous now. She's a very famous opera singer. You know when the doctor say Morgana is a very famous South America, well, that was my speech. But now it's true. I saw the future. So now Morgana became very famous. She's not here. She was invited to Palm Springs, but she doesn't have visa, and she doesn't have identity. She's not a man, she's not a woman, so Morgana right now is an unknown person in Mexico. So she's fighting to get the Morgana's name. She's very hard. She was invited, but she couldn't get the visa. And now she's thinking around the country, and she's living like a kind of Cinderella story. We went to France, we went to Paris, to Thailand, to Europe. And she used to, when we go together, she used to sing after the movie, she sings immediately. That is a show. But today we couldn't make it. So she changed, she has money now. She improved her life, she's surviving because of the music, and she moved to a nicer place, and she has like more, her life right now is like a, you know, it's the life that everybody deserves to have, you know?
So she's making her living singing?
Yeah, now, and she's famous now. She, right now she's in the TV, she goes everywhere. When we made the movie, she was wearing this red dress, and that was the only one that she had. And now she has the person who gave her all the clothes, and she's very fashion, very light. Mm-hmm. Yeah, she made it. So I made this movie all together, you know? I think that everybody was there, you know, trying to, because right now this is a movie, but when I was there, I say, I'm not, the movie is the second thing. We are trying to make the surgery. So I was there, I say, if I can make a movie, perfect, but we really, I don't know, it was a beautiful people around And it was very funny as well. I hear you laughing all the time. This is the feeling that we have during all this experience.
Did you know as you were filming, like the scenes in the doctor's office, did you know that the doctor was going to?
No. The doctor say, okay, come, I will help. You know, he said, and I have the feeling that it has to happen, you know? It's like, I believe in miracles. And he says, it's the destiny. And I have this very strong feeling that I'm here. We are 14,000 kilometers far away from home, so it has to happen. But I didn't know, and I was extremely nervous, you know? Morgana's crying, I was crying. They say, I couldn't, you know, I need to keep going, but I didn't know. I have the hope, because I spoke with him. And I said, listen, she's beautiful, you like the opera, she's this opera singer, you know, it's like, and when he say, I don't know if you remember, but he say, Morgana, he's very happy because Morgana is singing, and he's very grateful. So the doctor put in the same level, even if the surgery was $10,000, but for him, the show was the same price. And that's the beautiful part of him, so he didn't matter, you know, it's like, the show was also $10,000 for him. Because it was his event, 500 people from all over the world, all the experts. So, and I love that part from him, you know? He didn't mind about, the money wasn't different. It was, for him, was so important to have Morgana singing, for Morgana to have the surgery done. So that is the most human being. It's beautiful, the doctor. He came to Los Angeles 4 months ago for the screening. And yeah, it was very funny because he's an 82 years old. Man, and we went working together, and he was very fascinated by Hollywood. And we took 1,000 pictures. It was beautiful. They didn't watch the movie, the family either. So we screened this movie 3 blocks from his house. Not because I wanted to show the movie. Eh? It was because we was invited to a film festival, which was 3 blocks from the house. And they asked me, do you want to screen the movie in the theater? I say, no, I want to screen the movie outside, in the park. And we screened the movie for 1,000 people. And it was 3 blocks. They didn't watch it. So Morgana invited them to watch the movie. They don't want to do it. You know, this is a movie. This has an end. You know, that's the reason why I don't go inside the house. Because that is a very private, it's the privacy, you know. It's not mine. Even if making a movie, I don't have the right to be there, to go inside. But he's changing step by step. Morgana is still wearing. She needs to wear like men to get in, but at least she can be there. And this is very little, but for her it's big. So he's changing, not very fast. Honestly, it's very slow, but I don't know. And I think that they are not in the movie. I didn't show nothing about them because that is very private, you know? And we, as a filmmaker, I don't have the right to show them and to, I don't know, it's like, Morgana is trying to, they have the DVD in the house. So I think that they have the DVD in a sacred place, you know, like, they're gonna see the DVD every morning, like, oh, should we? No, I think one day he's gonna watch it.
For someone who's as well known now as she is, do you have a sense of how the family is dealing with that? With that fame?
And no, but the father, the family is very poor. So they don't know. And this is a very, very beautiful part because you know Morgana more than the family. So we as an audience, we know everything about her. Even when Morgana saw her vagina for the first time. Honestly, if I'm the father, I don't know if I'm ready to watch this movie. It's maybe very hard to have your son passing through all this situation alone. Which has with me, which is not a very good thing. But I think that, I don't know, it's very complicated. She is famous, but not in the bubble of his father. His father is a farmer, and he's a typical Mexican with mustache, and from the farms, from the countryside, and he doesn't watch TV, and horses, and... Yeah, this movie was, I began this movie a long time ago. So I have like more than 200 hours, but the movie was only one. So I took the decision to make a movie with what I had. For me, it's not even important the order, because when you make a movie, even if it's a documentary, the idea, the story, is that story. So, because when 200 hours, what should we do? Like, it's real life. So, there are so many things that happen in the movie, even in Bangkok, that is not in the movie, because was it, the movie is only 72 minutes. So, also, the movie is quite short.
And we had another question.
Did you
yeah.
I told you, it was like 3 years ago. And but you know, the movie is not about the time, it's just about what you feel during the movie. It doesn't matter if I tell you it's 3 years, 4 years, or in the movie it could be 4 days, 5 days.
Well, the reason why I asked is because the last scene, I wasn't sure how far after she came back from Bangkok, or was it before she
came back? Yeah, I answered this also before. Morgana is going every weekend, every Sunday, wearing a man's clothes. So Morgana is still going every Sunday, because now this is a good news. She can go, not to sleep, she cannot sleep in the house, but she can have lunch once a week. You know, for us maybe it's nothing, but for Morgana to have a lunch once a week for 3 hours, and the house is full of pictures of Morgana as Saul. So the father put in the walls pictures about his son, because, and also Morgana, when he's inside, she is he. So the father is, but he didn't watch the movie. So he doesn't know nothing about what you already know.
The second question was, what?
Oh my God, you had three questions.
Well,
can we share the question with other people?
Well, the second question was, what camera did you choose to use?
Canon 5D Mark II. Not Morgana. They know they didn't ask. It was just Morgana said that was having lunch. Say, oh, by the way, I'm a woman. And that was the yeah, the short introduction. They didn't ask, so they know. Well, in the country, everybody know. Every single person know that Morgana is a woman. But she was a woman, but Morgana has a surgery.
And what was the first part of your question?
The first question was, how did you meet her, and how did you go with her and follow her to Thailand to, you know, follow her life?
I met her in the cantina, and she was singing, and I was very shocked. Like, is she singing? Is she playback or is she singing? And then when she finished, I asked her, are you doing playback? And she said, no, her name was Maria. Because when I met Morgana, she changed the name 4 times. So, Morgana, so every year or every month I was calling Morgana. One day I was shooting in the church, and there was the priest. I said, well, now I want to do this with Samantha, a beautiful singer. And Morgana was on the stage, say, Samantha? I said, wow, I was in shock. And that day she changed the name, was Samantha for like a few months. That was very funny. Yeah, we went in a cantina, and since then I spoke with her the day after we have a breakfast, and then we became friends. To make this movie, you need to become a very good friend. Basically, Morgana, we are like very good friends now.
Yes, that's what I was asking. Did you know her before, or you just met her?
No, no, I just met that night.
Okay, thank you.
What I knew about this movie is that this story, I have this story before I met Morgana. So usually you meet the people and then you make the story. In my case, I had this story in my mind. I say, I want to make a movie about a trans person passing through this transition. So I was for 3 months walking around, not walking, but going to clubs, drag clubs, just interviewing the people and say, hey, how are you? And blah, blah, blah. So talking, conversations, and then I found the story.
Did you know she was... Were you aware that she was trans when...
When I saw her on the stage, no. No. I didn't... I was in a club for trans people, so doing shows, and they say, oh, but she's a singer, so... Yeah, that's the reason why... In the movie also, you don't know in the beginning, just because I didn't know either. So the idea was... You know, you don't have to tell the people, it's like... So you need to discover yourself. But the producers say, well, you should think about to cut it a little bit. Yeah, the first cut for me, everything was important. I say, no, don't cut here, it's very important, but it was a very long movie. And yeah, there are some parts that for me, just was very important. Well, Morgana, one of the deal that we made was, okay, I'm gonna make the movie, and then you're gonna come, you're gonna watch it. If you think that this movie is honest with your story, and then it is gonna be the movie. So this was the deal. So it's not the permission to her, but I say this movie is about you. It has to be very honest. So I don't wanna make a story that, because it's gonna be forever, this movie, so it has to be your story always, until the day that you die. But then there are some parts, for example, I don't know, the process is more painful than you watch it. If when you have the surgery, you need to use the dildo? Dildo? ¿Cómo se dice? Para el... ¿Qué momento más embarazoso? El dildo. ¿Alguien sabe cómo se dice dildo? Dildo, o sea. Such a word. So you have to use it every day. 3 times a day, sometimes. No, it's just to keep your vagina open. This is a scarf, you know, the body tends to close. If you don't use it, it's gonna close. And you need to use it. You have two options, have sex or use the dildo. So that's part,
dildo.
That part was very intimate, so. Look at your face, Sydney, are you shocked?
I'm shocked.
I guess the medical way is dilator.
Yeah.
And the dilation.
When Morgana, for example, I never saw her vagina. When I'm in the hospital, what you saw is what I saw also. I didn't. I don't have more footage of that part. That was my view, and I didn't want to, because she was naked, and I didn't.
We saw the bliss and the joy in her face when she saw her vagina for the first time. What about when she saw the film? What was her reaction? What did she think?
Cry, non-stop. When it finished, she was crying for like 30 minutes alone, but very deeply. Like she was crying I never saw a person cry like Morgana. And then she looked at me and say, "This is my story." And I say, okay, send here this paper, please. Give me your rights.
We have a question.
Long time.
1 year.
1 year?
Yeah, especially because as director, I was a nightmare for the person who made it. So because for me, everything was important. So it took me a long time to understand that the movie has to be 1 hour and 30 minutes, and not 6. So it's very hard, it was very hard. But it was a long process, especially because when I came back, I didn't have money to continue with the movie. So I didn't have money, because when I was there, I made this movie with $2,500. So that was my budget. Then I applied for a grant in Mexico, and I won for the post-production, which was $60,000, the post-production of the movie. It was very expensive, the production, because the sound was very bad, because I was doing the sound. So basically, what I say from the production, I spend in the post-production. But this was the only way to make this movie, without sound.
Second part of my question is, she is so self-possessed, she's so incredibly together as a person. Did she have a substantial support network of friends during those years of transition?
No.
Incredible.
She was, when I met her, she was alone. I remember one day, I saw her crying. We were having a coffee, and I said, "Why you are crying?" And it was her birthday.
Incredible.
Yeah, I cried like you, like now. I said, "Oh my God." So yeah, that was, in the beginning, was very sad. Her life was very, very sad. Because she was living alone you saw in the beginning, this is a very far place in Mexico City. It's the end of the city. So, yeah, that's the reason why this story is beautiful, because now she has like 8,000 friends on Facebook, and she, United Nations choose her to be the gay equality, I don't know, this project of United Nations, which has very long names, but there is a project that has Morgana's name.
Wow.
Great, thank you.
I think for me the biggest nightmare is to be the person who you are not, just to look the person you are not inside, so the identity. Because for me, this is not a trans movie. for me, it's universal. The dream of Morgana is everybody's dream, you know? In Morgana's case, it's just the surgery, but everybody, every single person has a dream. And this is not a gay movie either. And I think it doesn't talk about sexuality, it's identity. So Morgana really has a dream, and she's gonna fight forever, you know? She say, if I don't make this context, I have to say all my life. I wanted to tell this story because this struggle for me, I think it's one of the biggest ones. And I didn't know nothing about it. Say, I want to make a movie about something that I don't know nothing, just from this very, very beginning. I remember one day, my mother saw my Facebook. You know, when you are looking information in internet, then they send you publicity. And one day she was, my Facebook is full of drag queens and shows from Philippines, for all over the world. And she was, oh, what are you doing? I said, oh, nothing. I said, why? You have this publicity from Philippines, from the shows, and blah, blah, blah. So I get very involved with as I told you, most of my friends are trans now. And because it's 3 years, so basically that's people that I met, and this is my life. And yeah, so that was, I think that documentaries, for me, has to change you. Otherwise, I could make fictions. So when I try to, this is my first movie, so I say, I want to make a documentary because I want to change also. I don't want to just make a piece of art. I really want to change as a human being. And I changed it because now, it's like I understood something that, yeah, and this movie is when I released commercial in the theater in Mexico for the first time. So, yeah, it's amazing. It's going to be in the cinemas in April.
A little bit about that.
No.
Thank you. The culture in Mexico around the trans community, can you talk to us a little bit about that?
Yeah.
Is there support from families? Is there support from the government? Is there support from...
No.
Okay.
It's very sad. Mexico, after Brazil, is the second country in the world with the highest rate of murders with the trans community.
Okay.
So it's very sad. And I was telling you, when I began to research of this movie, I went with people in the police station or the police department of the crimes against the LGBT community. And I saw 300 folders of trans people who died. And the families doesn't even recover the bodies. They don't ask for it. It's the 60% of the body. They just left the body in that place. And that day, I was with three people in the room, and I'm the only one who survived. The other people just also died. So in Mexico, most of the people who I met during this movie, they died in the middle.
Mm.
Yeah, from different ways. But Mexico is terrible. In Thailand, it doesn't happen. It's very friendly, but they don't have any law to protect people. Mexico has the law, but not the society. The society doesn't support. So Mexico City now is like a bubble in the middle of the country. When I took the decision to make this movie, I knew it. You know, it's like, this is gonna be risky. But she was so, Morgana was like, even if with this possibility, she didn't deny, she never felt, she didn't cry. I was crying. I was very shocked. But she wasn't. She was like, it's fine. You know? You can see her all the time. She's smiling. But I think that this risk, it's going to be with me. That's the reason why in that part when I say I'm alone. And because I was the only person in the world, you know? It just was me outside waiting for the doctor, you know? And say, she's fine. Yeah, and what was the second question?
No. Well, you say that you are not thinking what risk are you going to take next, but...
I'm going to take risk, but not that kind of risk.
Oh, no,
but... Because I hope to find a producer to give me more than $2,500. If you are around there, raise your hands. And my next movie is going to be about trans story. It's going to be a narrative. It's going to be a fiction. It's going to be in a prison about... people who are women but living with men in prison. So I'm working inside for this right now in the prison.
I have no doubt that you're going to do a great thing. I mean, whatever you put your head on.
Thanks.
Yeah.
I thought I saw a hand up. Yes.
No, I didn't. It was real life.
It was okay.
Yeah. No, no, I didn't know. I was lucky. I think I was lucky because I have a movie and Morgana has a surgery. So everybody's happy.
Yeah, it was fantastic.
But no, I didn't know. When I came back to Mexico, I was like 8 months without, I didn't touch the material. I completely decided to leave what I was doing because I was very shocked. For me, this is not in the movie, but I was having like a disorder, mental disorder to me also. I have nightmares. It was horrible. But after the surgery, after when I came back for 1 month, it was very bad for me. And yeah, don't cry, but it was very bad.
I have one more question.
You're from Netflix.
Yeah.
I hope.
Okay.
I don't know. If this is a documentary, it's very hard. But right now, we won like 8 awards. Right now in Palm Springs, we became best of the best. Like our friend Prashant, that is there, that guy. Hey, Prashant, he made another amazing movie. And we were in Palm Springs. It's typical because this amazing, beautiful woman, Luisa, who organized, she watched my movie a few months ago. And she said, please come. And because I was in Palm Springs. And so thank you very much. Because I'm staying in her house also,
yes.
Which is beautiful. So thank you very much.
You're gonna have to find your boyfriend now too.
Thank you very much. And you know, if Gina say, if you know somebody from Netflix, if he sounds on, give him all my details.
Okay.
Thank you.